Simon & Schuster Audio presents The Healing of America. Written and read by Marianne Williamson.
Tough minds, tender hearts. According to ancient Chinese philosophy, the forces of yin and yang are like night to day, and darkness to light, feminine to masculine, inner to outer, and heart to head. They balance and border and complete each other, forming together a unified whole. To understand this dynamic is to be more fully aware of the rhythms that underlie all things. Our ultimate ground of being, what the Chinese call the Tao, is the mystical oneness out of which all worldly manifestation flows. To see how the greater oneness is in constant process of giving birth to two, that yin and yang might then come together again and give birth to another one, is to hold the key to greater understanding of anything in the world. Anywhere there's great duality, there's yin and yang, the eternal and the temporal, women and men, philosophy and science, vision and politics. To seek their balance in any situation is to seek the healing of the world. For according to Taoist philosophy, when yin and yang are out of balance, there is tension, disharmony, and discord in the universe. This audiobook is about the yin and yang of American history, the great duality of our miraculous beginnings, the ultimate tearing apart of our vision from our politics, and an effort that could now begin in earnest to repair the resulting wounding of our collective soul. In America today, we have critical problems that will not go away without collective dedication and effort. We must apply ourselves to serious problems with a concentration and a sense of purpose that we do not always summon in more normal times. Those who would have us gloss over those problems or deny them do not help us respond. Those who would lead us into cynicism or anger lead us away from healing. We need deep understanding of our collective problems. We need faith, and we need love. There is so much injustice in America today, and such a conspiracy not to discuss it. So much suffering, and so much deflection lest we notice. We are told that these problems are secondary, or that it would cost too much to fix them, as though money is what matters most. Greed is considered legitimate now, while brotherly love is not. Millions of us see this as an unacceptable violation of spiritual truth. We must create the restoration of our collective conscience and turn it into political will. The Declaration of Independence, the Constitution, the Bill of Rights, the Emancipation Proclamation, the Gettysburg Address, President Kennedy's inaugural address, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s letter from a Birmingham jail, these are like ancient tablets on which are inscribed our fundamental yearnings and highest hopes. At the same time, the Trail of Tears, the Vietnam War, systemic racism and economic injustice, official hypocrisy, violence, and exalted militarism form a dark and seemingly impenetrable force field, acting like a barrier before our hearts, keeping our hands from being able to grasp those tablets to our chest. It is the task of our generation to break through the wall before us, to atone for our errors, and reactivate our commitment to the promulgation of our strengths. It is not just that we need our sacred tablets. Our sacred tablets, to be living truths, need us. We must begin in earnest an archaeological dig into the American psyche, that we might retrieve the tablets on which are written the truths that set us free. This is not an easy assignment, for the layers of our denial are thick and encrusted. Billions of dollars are invested in our not seeing our own circumstances clearly. Then, in our blindness, we continue to support the very system that blocks our vision. Never has there been a time in our history when it was more imperative for the average citizen to think for him or herself. Often President Kennedy said, "We enjoy the comfort of opinion without the discomfort of thought." Everyone in America has opinions today, but too few of us are doing our very best thinking. Yet there is a new prophetic voice in America saying, as do all prophets, that we must repent, which literally means rethink. This new prophetic voice is not a soloist but a choir. This time, it will not be possible to silence one prophet, or even a few, and thereby stymie a broad-based impulse for decades. This time, a prophetic calling is seizing the hearts of a critical mass. It is a voice of group conscience and a redefinition of citizen activism in American democracy. There is about to rise up in us, if we wish, a new American consciousness and a renewed regard for the authority of the American citizen. That authority has not been taken from us so much as we have given it away. Therein lies America's disease. In reasserting the potential power of the American citizen, America will heal itself. Martin Luther King Jr. spoke often of our need to have tough minds and tender hearts. He himself displayed that combination brilliantly. Many tough thinkers in America today lack heart, while too many tender hearts lack mental and intellectual acumen. Fuzzy thinking is just one step above not thinking at all. We must pool our intellectual and emotional strengths to create an elixir of healing for our national distress. We have the yang, we must reclaim the yin. We have the intelligence, we must retrieve our souls. We will find a way to put the two together, and out of that union will flow such power of personal fortitude that a revolution of good will occur in America, a reassertion of hope and nonviolent authority. There is a wellspring of love and wisdom in each of us, which is itself, as both Gandhi and Dr. King proclaimed, a powerful political force. Our only true enemy is not people or institutions, but fear-laden thoughts that cling to our insides and sap us of our strength. We must make a stand for our better selves. We must recommit to essential truths, both spiritual and political. To some generations, President Franklin D. Roosevelt declared, "Much is given. From some generations, much is expected. This generation has a rendezvous with destiny." Roosevelt's words uttered in 1936 are relevant today, for our generation has a rendezvous with destiny as well. What we're now in the midst of deciding is whether we'll sleep through the date. Our alternative is to choose to awaken. American Renaissance. Within the next 10 years, America will have a renaissance or a catastrophe. Something is going to happen to take us back to who we are. If America were an individual seeking counseling, a good therapist might say, number one, you're not really sober. Number two, you're obsessed with material things and your spiritual life is begging for attention. Number three, you rarely take responsibility for your own problems and project a lot of blame onto other people. Number four, you've neglected your kids. Number five, the size of the elaborate security system around your house shows paranoid tendencies. Number six, you have a lot of amends to make. Number seven, your attraction to generals is neurotic. Whether the patient takes the cue or not remains to be seen. But for a person or for a nation, everything will erupt in time if we do not attend to the inner life. Radical beginnings. The curtain is now set to rise on the drama of the 21st century. We hold in our minds the possible scripts for its beginning scenes. As Thomas Paine proclaimed in speaking about the American Revolution, we have it in our power to begin the world over again. So do we. Like our founders before us, we live in one of those pregnant moments when a fundamental paradigm that has ruled one chapter of history is ready to pass and give way to another. Entire eras dovetail. At such times, the systems of life are more malleable than usual, and committed individuals have more power than they sometimes do to determine the course of history. It is ours to decide where history goes now, and Western civilization has but two directions from which to choose, transformation or disintegration. It behooves us at times such as these to consider deeply the historical examples of those societies that faced similar challenges and found a way to be reborn without first having to die. The American Revolution was a stunning social rebirth. Our founders repudiated systems of feudal authority that had been entrenched in Europe for centuries. The Americans declared all men to be endowed by rights given them not by a king, but by God. Our founders risked their lives to make that historical break from the past, boldly changing the course of human events. They reached beyond the accepted boundaries of what was to be expected.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.